Hi everyone, thanks for watching. Bit of a different video for me today, doing a hotel review from a recent stay in Dubai, staying at the Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. It's a Jumeirah property on the edge of the Palm, located just outside of Dubai. Five-star resort, quite nice, but we'll get straight into it. If you are interested in seeing the flights, click one of the pop-out banners above now, and that will take you to the outbound flight in BA First Class and the return flight in BA Club World, if you're interested. But let's skip straight on into the hotel review. The Jumeirah Zabeel Saray is on the outer edge of the Palm. Probably takes about 40-45 minutes in a taxi or an Uber to get there. It's right on the outside edge, so it's right at one of the tips of the Palms, really. Nice hotel, nice foyer area. You walk outside past the lovely water features into the main foyer area. We were staying for 10 days and we'd booked a junior suite. We'll talk about the junior suite later and what it gives you and why we booked that. First impressions of the hotel, really quite amazing, as you'd expect in Dubai. Very opulent, really kind of nice, really clean. We went during COVID, so extra cleaning measures in place and face masks. But as you can see, a bit of a stunning outset, really. You've got the main reception area and then a long corridor effectively up and down the hotel. And off it, you've got a number of shops and restaurants. We'll cover them later. Check-in was really easy. Yeah, not too much to say about it, really. You kind of spend a bit of time there sorting some bits and pieces out. And if you've got room credit, etc., that's where it'll all be discussed. But generally speaking, check-in pretty good and pretty thorough. So as I mentioned earlier, we'd booked a junior suite, so I'll give you a quick tour of that now. You enter, come down a little bit of a corridor and into the room. As you can see, nice big bed, nice big room really. Yeah, all the modern features, TV, smart TV, loads of chargers, loads of plug sockets, really kind of set up for the modern world. This is the main area, I suppose, the bedroom area, little workstation there if you need it. Clearly we're on holiday, we didn't need any work. A little chaise longue or long seat, and then I suppose this is what they'd call the junior part of the suite, really. It wasn't a separate room, which is a little bit disappointing, and it really should do with a TV there, so it was just a bit more space rather than a separate room, which is what we'd been hoping for. Work your way out onto the balcony. The views, I have to say, were really, really good. A little bit of a seating area, relatively comfortable, I suppose, and then you look out onto the rest of the Palm. Building in the distance there is the new part of the Atlantis, the residences that they're building in the new hotel. And then you look onto the pools and the kind of seating area of the hotel. So yeah, nice views, as you'd expect in Dubai, scorching hot. We actually booked the junior suite for a couple of reasons. One, we'd always quite like the suite, but actually it's the benefits it brings with it. And it is worth looking at this if you're checking out Dubai. A lot of them come with either executive lounges or club lounges. This quite often provides really good value, gives you probably 2 or 3 hours worth of free drink in the evening and some canapes. And it can really, whilst it might cost you more to book the room, it can really bring the cost of your holiday down if you like a few beers in the evening. So I would say it's really worth looking into. Loads of storage in the rooms, as you can see, for your luggage and your shirts and what have you. So loads of storage, nice safe if you need it as well. And then just moving finally into the bathroom. Really nice bathroom, huge marble bath that you can see there. I suppose my top tip for that would be it can take a little while to fill. There is a blind there if you want to bring that down, so if you're in the bath and don't want anyone in the main room to have a look at you, you can bring that down. Strange setup, shower this side, nice rainfall shower head at the top there, and then one door which either slides across to cover the toilet or the shower. Yeah, nice enough, just a little bit unique. But generally speaking, the room was really nice. The cleaning standard was really high. Just a little bit disappointed it didn't really have a separate room. And I mentioned the club room earlier. This is the one at the Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. So it's open all day for soft drinks and water free of charge that you can go into. It's a completely separate room. You can see it here, just set off the main corridor. Again, really clean, very attentive service throughout the day, whether it be during the social hours, as they call them, or whether it's during the day just for a soft drink or a little snackette, really. This is the menu that you can get during the 2 hours of evening drinks. Service really quick. Again, I was a bit nervous they might be a bit slow with that, but actually, they really, really weren't. And they're not too stingy with the measures either. So, yeah, all in all, a good addition, particularly if you do enjoy a couple of drinks in the evening. Those prices really do stack up in Dubai if you're not careful. So it's a good way of kind of getting value out of your room and the facilities available. And you may even actually choose to upgrade your room to a better room simply because of this saves the cost elsewhere. Not quite as ornate as the rest of the hotel, but a nice area and very good service. And then moving outside, you've got this stunning pool with some really, really great views. But just a bit of a word of warning, this is the only real pool in the entire resort, so it does get very busy, particularly at the weekends. It seems the Jumeirah Zabeel Saray is a locals' favourite, and it really seemed to pick up at the weekends when we were there, to the point where it was a bit too busy, if I'm honest. The pool is nice though, it's nice and chilled, which is kind of ironic. Normally you look for a heated pool, but in Dubai it's a little bit different if you want it chilled. If you couldn't find any room at the pool, which we couldn't a couple of days, they do have their own beach here now with loads of sunbeds, loads of shades, and constant cold water brought to you today. The water inside the palm is, I suppose, it's like a tepid bath, to be honest. You go in there to cool down, you end up sitting in a lot of hot water. So all the restaurants are based off the central corridor that runs the length of the hotel, really. It's not too far, they're probably about 300-400 metres, so you can walk up it and find them easily enough. Some of them did get booked up quite early, so it's always worth trying to get a table reservation during the day, either through the concierge or the club room if you've got access to it. And I think the other thing just to highlight with Dubai, we went on a deal through British Airways, which had half board and a number of other bits and pieces to it. But generally speaking, in some of the restaurants, there will be an additional charge for a number of things, even if you're half board. So it is just worth just keeping an eye out for that and making sure you're getting what you want, or spending what you want to spend, or getting the most out of your package. Also within the hotel is the Ottoman Spa. I didn't take too many images of that, but again, quite nice. You have to pay for those services, but quite a nice way to spend an afternoon or an evening, getting you fully relaxed into the holiday environment. So as you'd expect in Dubai, the hotel's very well decorated. This is inside the Imperium, which is the buffet area. Very well done, very deceiving. It's not as big as it looks, but the use of mirrors and lighting's very creative here. Food stand for a buffet is really, really quite good, to be honest. Lots of variety. You don't really need a booking to come here. Just sort of drop in and pick the food you want and go up as many times as you want, really. Yeah, not too much to add. It's a buffet. And then all the other restaurants have kind of got themes so that you feel like you're in a different place. This now coming on screen is the Rib Room, probably the more expensive of the additional restaurants, where you will pretty much need a supplement for almost most things. Very much like an American style restaurant. If you've ever been to Vegas, it feels a bit like a Vegas-y restaurant. Very nice food though, steaks were good. Yeah, a little bit pricey, but it is good quality food. And then just another example of the theming is the Indian restaurant called Amala. An authentic Indian cab, apparently, is outside of it, just so you can have a look there and see how deep they're going with the theming. And inside the restaurant, again, really spacious, really well done. It does feel like a different place and a different establishment. Food, again, was really nice. In fact, the food across the hotel is all really nice. It doesn't blow my socks off in any way, shape or form, but actually it's quite a nice place to stay and spend a few days and eat too much and drink too much, probably. And I think in fairness, there's a few things that we've missed out on in this trip. We didn't realise it until it was way too late. Because it's part of the Jumeirah group, we could have gone to any of the Jumeirah hotels and used their facilities in exactly the same way, whether that be the club lounge or the restaurants, including our half-board package. So a bit of a lesson learnt for us there, really, that actually do a bit of due diligence and make sure you understand what you can and can't do, because we could have gone to probably 5 or 6 different other hotels and enjoy some different experiences, but lessons learned. So what do I feel about the Jumeirah Zabeel Saray? It's a nice hotel. Look, there's no doubt about it. It's a five-star hotel. It's really nice. Little bit disappointed in the junior suite that it didn't have separate rooms. Little bit disappointed with the pool outside, with there being only one pool and the busyness of it. Truthfully, I think there's probably some other hotels that I'd stay at in ahead of this one. But please don't let it put you off. Look, it's a really nice hotel. It's clearly liked by a lot of people. It offers quite a bit. But I just think there's probably a few out there. For example, the Palazzo Versace. There's a card above the screen now, which we've stayed in previously. I think I'd rather go back there than come back here. But please draw your own conclusion. It's only my opinion and view. Thanks ever so much for watching. Take care. Please leave a like. And if you like the content, subscribe to the channel. Thanks.